Do subscribe to Ikeda channel and press bell icon to get updates about latest engineering, HSE and IIT JEE main and advanced videos.
Hello students, today we are studying chapter Human Skeleton, and in that we are studying topic Structure of a Contractile Protein. Now if I say about contractile proteins, the contraction as well as relaxation of muscles not only depend on actin and myosin but other kinds of proteins, and these proteins are your contractile proteins. So let's study about them today. Contractile proteins basically constitute three different things: your tropin, tropomyosin and F actin. Now they also consist of a globular head and the leg region, and their bending or movements are always directed in opposite directions depending upon the way contraction or the way the sliding filament is moving. Structure of contractile protein. Now contractile proteins basically includes your F actin, tropin and tropomyosin. Now each actin filament, which is the thin filament, is made up of two F filaments simultaneously that are always helically or coiled to each other, and when they are coiled to each other, the F actin is a polymer of monomeric G globular actins, or a combination of G globular actins. These two filaments of other protein, that is tropomyosin, also run close to your F actin throughout its length. So I could say that all the three, troponin, tropomyosin and F actin, are embedded together or crisscrossed and helically coiled against each other. A complex protein, which is troponin, is distributed at regular interval on the tropomyosin region. Now what happens in resting state, that a subunit of troponin, one of the proteins, mask, or basically it covers the active binding site for myosin on the actin filament, and due to which the sliding filament theory or the movement of light and dark bands or contraction and relaxation in the muscle contraction can happen. Also at the same time, calcium binding or the movement of thin and thick filaments in the Z and L lines are possible. So students, today we studied about contractile proteins and how does this contractile proteins help myosin as well as actin to work in very efficiently. I hope students, we are all clear with this concept of contractile protein. Thank you.